Hello everyone, this is the Algerian General and welcome into a new episode of the Modding Bootcamp. Before we get into that, I would love to first of all to apologize for the recent inactivity. I haven't made any videos since last summer. I've been mostly busy with school, busy with university and modding and so on, but hopefully now I'll be able to make some more time for the YouTube channel. And of course, since the last video I made, the channel has actually broken over 350 subscribers. I would love to really thank you guys for that. I truly appreciate the support, and it really pushes me up. And you know, we might actually have a special event at 500 subscribers, perhaps. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. But for today's episode, we are mainly going to look at scripted effects, scripted triggers, and scripted localization. So, this tutorial is mainly destined to people who already grasp, you know, how modding works, who already understand how effects, triggers, and so on work. This could be perhaps an intermediate level modding tutorial. So if you guys have no idea on how, you know, those things work, I highly advise you check the previous videos, especially the first episode, since that one pretty much encompasses how the whole thing works. So what are these scripted effects, scripted triggers, and scripted localization? So first of all, if you go to your mods folder or to your vanilla folder and you go to common and then you go to here, you can actually see scripted effects, localization, and triggers. So what are these? The answer is fairly simple. Basically, sometimes you don't want to write a whole lot of bunch of code, right? Sometimes, you know, you are in a situation where you have to make some really complex effects, really complex triggers, but you don't really want to code them in every single time, right? So what do you do? The answer is fairly simple. You basically use scripted effects or scripted triggers. Basically, what these do is that they are shortened versions of your code, right? Scripted localization is something else that we will look at in the second part of the video. But for now, let's just focus on scripted effects and scripted triggers. So I'm going to give you a small example here. For instance, if we take a look at the Germany ones, So for instance, this is the Mifo bills level up. Okay, so maybe you're aware of this, but the Mifo bills, the more you pay them, the more political power they will cost. And that is actually done by swapping the ideas. So they actually have different levels. Level 1, level 2, level 3, all the way up until level 18, I believe. Now, in the vanilla game, playing as Germany, it's going to be a lot of events and decisions that will make you level up. But the coders didn't really want to code all of this stuff, all these, you know, didn't really want to put all of these, this code, these lines of code, every single time they had to. So what they did was, basically, they put it somewhere, like here, right? So for instance, they put all the effects they want. And then what they do is that in the event or in the decision or in the focus, they basically put ger_mifo_builds_level_up equals yes. Now, when you do that, it basically tells the game, hey, I want you to run that scripted effect, and it will run what you have right here. I'm going to try to give you a simpler effect or a simpler example here, assuming I can find one in vanilla. For instance, this one. This one, for instance, is used for, I believe, emergency factory conversion, right? So the emergency factory conversion basically picks one of your civilian factories and, you know, it makes it into a weapon or military factory, right? Now, this is the whole code necessary to perform such an operation. They don't really want to copy this every single time they have to. They don't put it in all the events, decisions, and focuses they want. So they basically shorten it into this, replace save with arms factories. And they just, in the event, for instance, they put this equals yes, and the game will simply execute these lines of command. So, long story short, scripted effects are basically a way for you to save a repetitive bunch of effects, right, into one single line. It's usually useful for complex operations and repetitive operations. Basically, when you have multiple events, multiple decisions, multiple focuses that pretty much do the same effect, right? Here's perhaps another example. Germany Democratic Nations AI strategies. So this is, for instance, a lot of code, as you could see. This basically makes Germany, you know, hate the Soviets, hate the Italians, hate the Poles. They will ignore the Poles, but they will not befriend them, and they will not ally with them. So you get the idea, right? In a regular event, they would actually put all these lines of code into that option, for instance. But in this scenario, they decided, hey, why not shorten it into only one line of code, which is Jura Democratic Nations AI strategies, right? And they basically put in the event, this equals yes, right? And it will execute all of these things. So this is, I believe, a very powerful and very useful tool when it comes to complex mechanics or events and decisions and focuses that have a very long and a very complex set of effects, right, that the game has to execute, sorry. Now, the exact same thing can be said about scripted triggers. They're basically triggers, but instead of putting all the code, right, in that event or in that focus or in that decision, it's basically put in one single line of code. Now, of course, you still have to define them here, but I will show you an example from vanilla if I can. Yeah, this one. Let's see. Is Japan or ally of Japan, right? So basically, as you could see here, this here is a set of triggers, right? It's not just one, it's a bunch of triggers, you know. It's either you're Japan, you're in a faction of Japan, or you are a subject of Japan, right? But since the guys in Paradox didn't really want to write all of these things in the same time, and every single time they had to, you know, scope for a nation that is Japan or an ally of Japan or a puppet of Japan, what they did was they shortened it into one line of code. Perhaps a different example would be, Czech has focus tree to switch to fascism. Okay. Let's see. Czech has focus tree to switch to communism. These are basically, as you could see, very complex sets of triggers that are shortened into only one line of code. So that's pretty much it. You know, there's nothing to it. Maybe I can show you some examples from DH if I can. Let's hope I don't spoil anything, because, really, there's been a lot of work going with DH in the past few weeks, in the past few months, and a lot of them, I don't really believe they are ready to be showcased just yet. Let's see. This one, for instance. DH general scripted effect. So, move economic level down 1. This here is a scripted effect. So it basically will execute all of these things that you see right here. And the idea is very simple, is that it takes your current economic law or your current, economic level, and it, you know, brings it one level down. So for instance, if you have undisturbed isolation, it will make you isolationist. If you have isolation, you go to civilian, you go to low economic mobilization, and so on. The same happens, of course, with moving conscription laws down 1 level or bringing it up 1 level. Another example might actually be the DHSS set templates. Now, this is only one line of code, okay? One line that you put in your event, for instance. And the thing it will do, of course, I'll try to find the event for you guys to see how it works. Should be right here. Solve. Nope. SS Infantry Division. I have to find that. Yeah, here we go. DH set, SS set templates equals yes. So instead of me putting all this code you see right here, I only have to put this line of code. And of course, equals yes. Same, I guess, same work with triggers. So that should be all for scripted effects, and scripted triggers. Now we get into the second part of this video, which is scripted localization, right? So maybe you guys remember in the new focus tree they made for Germany, if I am playing as, you know, regular fascist Germany, there's this one focus called KDF Wagon. Kraftdurchbrüder Wagon, basically. But if I become the Kaiserreich, you know, I take the whole oppose Hitler path and so on, then the focus name will change to the Kaiserwagen. And if I'm not mistaken, if I go communist, then the name will be Volkswagen. So what is causing this to happen? What is causing the change? What's making the focus tree or the focus itself change name depending on ideology? Well, that's what scripted localization is all about. Scripted localization is that you create a key, okay, a key that changes its localization key depending on the triggers you set. I know it might sound complex, it might sound complicated at first, but let's go to it one by one. Not so sure if Paradox have actually used them. Yeah, they actually used them for Germany. So I'll be able to show it right here. By the way, for those that are wondering, I'm currently using Sublime. No, not Sublime. I'm using Visual Studio Code. I'm probably going to make a separate video on how to set it up with the current setup that I have right here, which is, I'd say, the best way for you to do any sort of HOI IV modding or even Stellaris or EU4. It's amazing because, you know, it gives you what errors you have. It's also color-coded. Even, you know, autocomplete stuff and so on. So here is an example, which is the KDF wagon example I used previously. So this here is the name or the key, okay? So this is what you will put in the focus name. Then you have the text. So this is a trigger. So if the trigger is met, then this here will be replaced by this. I know it might sound complicated, but I will explain to you now how it works exactly. For that, I'm going to have to open up the localization file for the German focuses. So let's open it up and let's look for get KDF wagon name. So, okay, this is the focus name, okay? And here it's set to root.getKDFWagonName. Now, root basically means Germany, right? Because it is the nation that has the focus here. While this here is the key, like I mentioned earlier. Of course, you have to put some brackets in between so that the game realizes, hey, this is a key, right? Alright, so here's how it exactly works. Is that these here are the keys that will replace getKDFWagonName, okay? So for instance, if I'm playing as Germany, and my government is neutral, then the localization key will be German Kaiser Wagon name. So instead of this thingy in brackets, it will use this, which is Wilhelm Wagon, right? If I am communist, it will use Volkswagen, this key. If I am, you know, regular Germany or fascist Germany, I will use basically KDF Wagon. And that can actually be seen right here. So communist and democratic will use Volkswagen, else it will just use KDF Wagon. Simple, right? When you don't define a trigger, it's going to be the default name that the game will use. Alright? That's pretty much how it works. The same have actually been used with get the Hermann Göring worker name. It was also used for the get Vietnam owner, for instance. So whoever is controlling Vietnam, for instance here it's Japan or France, get German technology name. Overall, you know, there's a lot of interesting things you get here. The other thing you could do is here, like you can see with the Get Wehrmacht Anger Revel, it basically says, hey, the Wehrmacht is angry, they're pissed off, or they're worried, they're plotting, they're rebellious. The level basically is a localization key that the game, you know, shows you, basically, according to the variable that you have, right? So it checks the variable and then tells you, hey, they are loyal, or they are calm, worried, angry, and so on. And the same can be used here with the SS. So it's overall interesting, right? this is a very powerful tool, and if it's used, I guess, in the right way, then you can actually yield some amazing results. I believe that should actually be all for today's video. I know it was relatively short, and of course I apologize for that, but I kind of wanted to, you know, reboot my channel with something simple, yet something that's quite useful that a lot of people would definitely love to use. Hopefully in the upcoming few days I'm gonna make some more tutorials, a bit more focused on GFX this time, so I'm probably gonna do some focus icons, how to colorize portraits, maybe even 3D models, right? How to actually, you know, add new 3D models to the game, although that's a tutorial that's a bit too complex, but I'll still try to, make it as simple as I can for those that are not very much familiar with 3D modeling. And besides, of course, the whole modding co-op, or the mod, not the co-op, the modding bootcamp, I'm going to attempt, right, to do some gameplays, right? Maybe some HOI IV, maybe some War Thunder, maybe some Wargame Red Dragon with Ash and Shadows. You know, it all depends on how much time I have and so on. And I will, of course, continue with the whole mod critic series I've been doing since a good amount of time. It actually, I don't know, it's been one of my most viewed series so far, especially the End of a New Beginning review. What I'm going to do is review some new mods and review some updated mods. For instance, Iron Curtain, which has been radically changed since the last time I made a review out of it. That should be all for today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please leave a comment in the comment section down below. That was the LGN General, and I will see you guys in the next one. Cheers!